Dynamico on the beat. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Oregon State Dynasty on my YouTube channel here. As you can see, we're back in the home studios today, back from college for a couple months, coming back for the holidays and whatnot, getting a little break from school. Not done yet, still got a few exams to take and whatnot, but a lot more time on my hands, and now I can go a little bit more crazy during the game because I'm in my own space and I don't have people living next to me knocking on my door, you know, getting on my nerves about me screaming and stuff. But anyways, we are back. We're taking on Cal today. We are 8-0, number one team in the country, baby. Still in search of the school's first ever national championship. I didn't know this until I looked today. Oregon State has never won a national championship in college football. So we've been there once, we didn't win it. So we need to change that. And we are gonna continue to try and work our way there. Right now, looking to get to 9-0 with a win. Cal is 3-5, not particularly a good football team. Last year, they gave us a little bit of trouble. I think it was a 35-28 game going into half, and then we came out and did what we do. We beat everybody handily in the second half, came away with a pretty easy W. This year, though, we want to try and dominate all four quarters and just put another win on the board, right? So let me update you on a couple of the records real quick I went over in my last game, which I'll link right here. So I mentioned Bryson Lewis, our quarterback, is in the hunt for a couple school records, and he got a little bit closer yesterday. School record for passing touchdowns, like I said, 79, held by Derek Anderson, who's the quarterback in the early 2000s. Lewis has 74, so he needs 5 more to tie, 6 more to break it. Now, like I said, the actual record is 83, and it's held by Sean Mannion. So that one's still also breakable. We have between 5 and 6 games left with the Pac-12 championship and the national championship or bowl game. What else? Career passing yards. Lewis up to 9,557 now. The record in the game is 11,249, held by Derek Anderson. And the actual record is Sean Mannion, 13,600. So we are under 2,000 to get to the record in the game. Under 4,000 to get to Mannion's in real life. Now, I don't think we're going to get to Mannion's unless Lewis goes on some crazy tear. But if we could set the records in the game, that'd be cool. And then passing yards in the season, probably not going to get this one. It is 4,058 in the game. Lewis not even at 2,000, and we're over halfway through the season. So that one's out of the books. But he is, that's fine. Can't even do math. 5 away from tying the record for career passing touchdowns and 6 away from setting the new one in the game. It's very complicated. I wish the game would just update its school records. But that's that. Eric Day, another guy I mentioned last time, trying to break the school record for career touchdowns. It's 20 in the game. He is at 16, so he needs 4 more to tie and 5 to break it. Now the actual record is Brandon Cooks with 24. Also breakable. All he needs is 8 touchdowns in the last 6 games to get there. But this hasn't really been a year where we've had a featured wide receiver, right? It's really just been kind of a team thing. We've kind of spread the ball around. The run game has been the big thing recently. So, you know, I'm not going to go into the games thinking, oh, I need to break this or that record. If it happens, it happens. And if it doesn't, so be it. But anyways, a couple more things to highlight before we get into the game. Players of the week. I keep this documented every time we have someone. Not nationally, but Pac-12, it was actually Bryson Lewis, who didn't even play that good of a game. I mean, he had 2 interceptions and 1 passing touchdown, but on the ground, 11 carries, 127 yards, 3 touchdowns, so a total of 4. So, you know, when you look at it like that, you know, good game. And then Cal actually had a guy on the list as well here, Tim Johnson, a guy we're probably going to see today, a linebacker, had 2 interceptions, so something to look out for. One other thing, with the Heisman watch here, and we got a familiar face there, Ryan Culver, 3rd in the Heisman voting now, 19 carries, 139 yards, last game against Stanford. He's starting to emerge as the number one running back, starting to hit his hit his ceiling, his potential with it, you know, he's had it for a while. So that's that. And then one last thing, we'll look at the conference standings. We're number one in all three polls, so there's no sense looking at them. Here is the Pac-12 North standings. So you could see everybody has between 2 and 4 losses. So obviously we haven't clinched it yet. We have 4 games left, and they're all going to be North Division. We got Oregon, Washington, and Washington State, and then Cal, obviously, today. Cal's last in the division right now. So, you know, obviously we don't plan on losing. So as long as we just win our last 4 games, there's nothing to worry about here. But Stanford would be the biggest challenger, I guess, because they're in second. Let's take a look at the Pac-12 as a whole. So every year, it's always us at USC, and that's the case once again. UCLA has an outside chance, but they're 3-2 in conference. USC is 6-1, so I don't think UCLA is taking down USC. So every year that we've been in the Pac-12 championship, it's been Oregon State, USC, every single year. So I guess we're going to have that again. And that should be a great rematch. We played them earlier in the year. I'll link the game right here if you haven't seen it. Really good game. I don't want to spoil it for you. Just go watch it. I think that was the only other thing we wanted to look at pregame. Recruiting, I'll go real quick. Just there's not much here. We're not really recruiting anybody anymore. We have 13 commitments, and all the positions I wanted to fill are filled. So there's 3 guys left on here where, you know, if we want them, if they want to come to our school, fine. But we're not really recruiting them that hard. We have 12 or 13 guys leaving, so, you know, if a couple go to the draft, maybe I'll snag a few more. But a really solid class here, number 2 in the country behind Penn State, I believe. Notre Dame. We'll probably drop because we're not bringing anybody else on board for now, at least, so not much to talk about there. But I'm just excited to get into this, man. Also, if you're new here, please subscribe, like the video, you know, share it to your friends if they like this content. I'm trying to get to 100 subs before the end of the year, so if you guys could help me out with that would be great. This channel has grown tremendously since I started this already. We're up to 74, and I started at, like, 40, I want to say. But I do a lot of cool content here. I do, you know, highlight films, you know, I do some just things of that nature, highlight films for various guys in college, and then obviously this, but I'm going to keep, you know, trying to expand my channel. So like, share, sub, trying to get to 100, road to 100. Let's do it. Let's get into this game.
Hard work, the effort, the energy, the dedication.
Cal loses the toss. We decide to kick first. Let's go.
Sullivan has the ball set how he wants it. And we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the do as they come out onto the field.
Screen.
There's a strike complete. He's tackling at the 33.
Nice play to come out with, and their credit.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense, and in this case, he did.
Nice job. Blitz here. Read option. Nice. Drew Davis comes downhill, makes the tackle. 3rd and inches. Let's go. Let's get off the field. Gonna bring him again.
This crowd comes to play themselves.
Blitz didn't get home. Ewing gets beat one-on-one.
Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
He's under some heat. And he's
down. Yes. All right, we got a sack. They tried to go fake screen wheel there, but Zach Bellamy, the D-tackle, gets in, makes the sack. Good coverage there. We didn't get fooled by the fake. Second and 12. Now we got a behind schedule. We can hop into nickel. Keep getting blocked up in the second level. I'm trying to come downhill and make the play. Looked like they went slot option there. We're in nickel, so this isn't a good situation for us. There we go. Sent a blitz that time, exactly from that side. This is the down. We got a win right here. Second and 9. We're going to go safety blitz. Let's get him behind schedule. In the gun. Five wide receivers. Read option. Yes! There we go. Third and 12. Let's go. Third down. They can't hear a thing down. Alert screen. Screen. Oh, no, it's not. Yes, there we go. Looked like a screen to me. We went back. Nobody was open. And looks like he was trying to throw it somewhere, but he got hit as he was throwing it. Falls incomplete. And they're going to try and kick a long field goal. It's going to be a 56, 57 yarder. So we got a return guy back there as well. California is looking to go up by three. In there. The kick is up. Oh, hits the crossbar, falls short. Let's go, baby. Big stop for the boys on the opening drive. And great starting field position. Let's go. All right, going to open it up with a midline read option. Nice and simple, something to ease in. Maybe even score. Keep. All the blocks. Oh. Culver came up and tried to give me a block, tried to follow him, but I guess I got tackled before that. Good start. All right, come back with another run. They're going to press the corner here, so be wary of a blitz. Looks like he did come on a blitz, so we just go up the middle. Culver gets forward. Let's slow it down now, fix up the personnel. Getting something else. All right, going to spread it out in the pistol. Coming out with halfback dive, and we're going to stick with that. Oh, they're bringing the safety blitz. Late, actually. All right, give me a screen. Let's try that. Yes, make a miss. Nice. All right, didn't really get any blocking help on the outside, but Culver made the play himself. That works. Stick with that. All right, they're spread out. Let's just hand it off. I think I don't really want to do the read option concept part of it. Go right up the middle. Nice. Good running. We saw that linebacker sitting in the middle there, so we weave in between the blockers. Get a little bit extra there if we, as opposed to if we were to just go straight. Let's come back with a counter. Unless they do that. Looks like we'll be throwing for the first time here. Alright. Out. Nice. Travis Moore burns him on the flag route, makes the catch. Couldn't stay in bounds, but we'll take it. All right, coming back with a power run here inside the 10. Now we'll switch that. Don't like that either. All right, we'll stick with this though. Keeper, got room.
Yes, sir. Let's go!
Midline read option for the win there. Lewis up the middle, puts his head down, doesn't fumble, and we got great blocking up the field. That's my center there, 69 at the 1 yard line, getting a great push for me, and we walk into the end zone. Easy six. All right, they had a pretty good drive there, but it stalled inside our 50-yard line, so we're going to try and do a better job here. They're coming out five wide. Need to go out there and play. In the shotgun and five wide outs. Nobody's open. He's going to go deep. That's got to be picked. Oh, wow.
Tackle right away.
I think that was my backup strong safety there getting exposed. Loses that jump ball.
They come out in a five wide set.
All right, we're going to go cover four this time. Should have had that interception. Threw it up into double coverage. Checks it down. Come up, make the tackle. Nice hit. All right, second and two. Told him to do a field goal. All right, this might be a time where they motion in a receiver to play running back. So, zone blitz. No, we'll go man. Doesn't look like they are. Nobody's open.
He's under pressure.
Oh, cut back.
It right in his hands.
There it is. All right, so Cal goes five wide, gets a huge chunk play on that jump ball. Should have been intercepted. And they get a touchdown.
This team has
got to play better defense than that.
It's tough to trust. We get a tie game at 7-7. And he got all of this one.
Had a great drive on the on our opening drive of the game. It was led by the run. So let's dial up another good one here.
For the running back last time.
Got soft coverage on the outside. Throw it away. Good zone coverage from Cal there. Tried to get out, make something happen, but their DN crashed outside. Played that one well. Just trying to run it here, get back on schedule. Looks like they're blitzing here. Gonna flip it. Same look, okay. We're gonna go to a pass then. No, we'll stick with this actually. Good blocking, slide through there. All right, pretty good. I hate when I get held up in my alignment like that. It kind of slows my momentum. So we get seven, third and three, very manageable. We'll bring that wing in, pick this up. Looks like they're gonna force us to pass the ball today. So, you know, obviously we're built to do that if we have to, but I like to set up the run instead of, I like to run the ball instead of the pass. Give, the block. Woo, nice spin. Nice run there for 13, good first down. 4 for 36 for Culver now, he's off to a great start. Setup play. Now these things tend to screw you over, so let's make sure we do everything as good as we can here. A's open, boom. More in open space, beautiful man. All right, we'll get into a different personnel set here. Slant bubble.
First down.
Unless they open up the middle like that. But I can't tell if that running back's coming down on a blitz or not on the right side. We'll go with it though. He is. Alright, we'll take it though. Good 5 yards. Let's go hurry up. Let's go right back to that play. Let's see what they do. Alright, two high safeties. Soft coverage. We'll run it again now. Yeah. We're gonna go run it again. Blitzing again, same one. Right up the middle for Culver. Nice, way to line the football. It's like a shot. We'll stick with it. I might actually pass it this time though. If they're gonna bring that same blitz, let's just go. Man to man, hit the curl, boom, make a miss. All right, inside the 10 again, let's go. Bringing in the wing, except on the right side this time. Well, it's on the same side, actually. We're going to look to go to the right side this time out of this formation. Though. Keep, lead block, boom. Lewis again, second of the day. Fifth in the last two games on the ground. He's eating, and we go up 14-7. We gotta figure out our defense here, so we're gonna go nickel strong and see if this works. We're gonna run more man blitz instead of zone. Good run. Their offense is predicated on this guy right here, Sean Talley. He has about 800 yards on the season. So, you know, it's a run-first offense for sure. Taking off.
Looking for the corner.
Nice job, Phil. Phil Hall comes downhill, makes a difficult tackle in space. Bring him down for just a 1 yard gain, second and nine. Read option. Down there. Nice job, Butler. We didn't get there, but Butler came across to make the tackle. Third and four. Let's go. Closing seconds of the first quarter. Let's see if they get that last playoff.
Really a tough spot for an offense.
All right, zone blitz. Over the middle. Let's go, baby. Receiver was open, but we dropped a D tackle right into that hook zone over the middle. Gets a nice shot on the receiver, falls incomplete, and they're going to have to punt the ball away. I didn't see who it was. I think it may have been Jeff Gates. I'll have to check that post-game. But great play there by that defensive lineman. And the perfect blitz, zone blitz concept, excuse me. Good blocks. Oh, Ewing. All right. That's probably our best punt return of the season right there. 26 yards. Great way to end the first quarter. 14-7. We're starting to figure it out defensively, and on offense, we're 2-for-2. So let's just keep playing mistake-free football and running it up their throat, baby. All right, we're going to feed Culver until we can't anymore. Every time he touches the ball, it's at least a 5 yard gain. Well, they're daring us to pass it here. So we're going to go, right back to it. Zone, dump it down to Wallace. Falls over two defenders and gets the first down, baby. Good work. That's going to be the thing today. Can we just dissect their zone coverages and make the right read? That's going to be the battle today. And it's easier said than done. I also want to keep running the ball, though, so that'd be nice. We're going to do it right here. Here we go. Sweet play. Get the blocks. Sideline, stiff arm. All right, not bad. We'll take five. See if he can just win one of those one-on-one battles, though. It's a home run. All right, gonna go strong slot this time. So we got like the fullback, to the right. We're going read option out of this. Keep. Oh, gets out of that. Oh. Cal sends the perfect blitz. We broke the first tackle, but the second one got there, and Lewis fumbled, but we do jump on it. Thank the Lord. Oh, that could have been bad. We'll take it, though. It's like it never happened. And we got the first down out of that, so you know what? No harm, no foul. All right. We're going to run it here. It's 5-on-5 in the box. Let's go. Good hole. Sort of. Good 5 yard gain. I mean, that's fine. We'll nickel and dime our way up the field like that. But I want to see if they'll let us run this time. Please. Thank you. All right, here we go. Inside zone. Been trying to run it all day. We're up the middle. Nice. Nine more, man. Our offensive line is doing a beautiful job blocking for the run so far. We're going to come out with it here, though. Got a weak flood play. So I'm looking for the slot here on the out route wide. I will pass this one. Man coverage, drags open. Campbell underneath. Nice. Let's go hurry up. We're exposing him out of this personnel set. This spread formation in the pistol. Second and three, come right back and run it. Right up the middle, man. Unless they bring the safety blitz. All right. And they're gonna give me the slant bubble as the audible here. X is open. Boom. Nicholson in for the touchdown. Let's go, baby. And with that one, Bryson Lewis, 75 career touchdown passes within 4 of the record and 5 of breaking it now. So keep that running tally.
And he converts the extra point. He sends this one deep. And he's taken down.
right, nickel strong worked last time, so we're going to go back to it once again. It's kind of like nickel, but you bring in a heavier linebacker to cover and play the run. Read option, come downhill, let's go, baby, Jordan Washington. We're starting to figure him out. Gives it this time, bounces it outside, get down there. Oof, we came completely across the field to make that play. We need somebody else to help us out there. But third and one, we didn't make the tackle, but we set it up for it. So third and one, let's go. We're going to blitz. Got to get home here. They passed out of it. Receiver was wide open. I wasn't sure who I was covering pre-snap. I couldn't tell, and it was too late, so I don't think that was my guy. Good conversion from Cal there. Read option. Butler's there. Nice hit. Let's go. Playing really well against the read option so far today. Second and nine. This is the money down. Let's go zone blitz. Counter, let's go. JT Brown blows the play up off the edge. Would have been there anyways with the corner blitz, but look at that, man. Destroys that polling guard and makes the play. Third and 10, let's go. Nobody's open. It's gonna have to be a cutback, but he's not gonna be able to throw it because he gets sacked. Phil Hall gets it this time, finally. When we rush four, we need to be able to get home, and so far we have been. But they've had a couple of cutback plays already. They scored off of one, so thank goodness we got the sack there. They couldn't get that pass off. And they're going to punt it this time instead of kicking another long field goal. Another great stop. He's going to try to cough and corner this one. Ooh. Good punt. All right, so we're going to be inside the 5-yard line almost. We've run the ball so well, though, we're not too scared. We're just going to try to run our way out of this situation. Just helping guys get back into the huddle. Like they're sending up, they're blitzing, obviously. They're going to be able to go inside zone here. Wide open. Nice run, Colbert. Way to get those extra yards, too, off the contact. Yeah, the contact. 10 for 80 so far. He's having a day. 8 per carry. Keep it on the ground. 2:30 to go, so we can kind of run some clock here and try and get a 96-yard drive for a touchdown. Woo! Oh, he almost took that thing all the way. 25 yards there. What a spin. And just like that, he's over 100 yards. I think for the third game in a row, he's on a bit of a tear here. Keep feeding him. I think this one's gonna go to the other running back though. Yeah, all right, this one's going to Reynolds. I'll still run it though. They're going with their three linebackers this time. Late blitz sent. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Didn't pick the right hole that time. Are gonna pass it this time, depending on what they do defensively. They're spread out, so we're actually gonna run it. I don't like this play though, so no, screw that. Into this. Get the running back. Oh, good defense by the linebacker. I thought Culver had him beat up the field. Third and 8 now. Should have stuck with the original play that I came out with. I liked that one. But 3rd and 8, we can convert this. No worries at all. Let's just go back to that play I was going to run last time. 3rd and 8, let's go. Going to motion out Culver. We got an out route there and in route from Day. Boom. Good separation for Campbell. He's up the sideline. Breaks a tackle, too. 25 yards. Let's go, man. 5-star recruit. One of the very few on this team. You expect those kind of plays from him. That was certainly 5-star separation on that play. All right. We got to keep an eye on the time, though. I forgot about that a little bit. 1:23. We got a counter. We're going to audible to the counter. Inside's open. gets out. Nice. Takes a minute for Culver to get going, but once he gets that second gear, man, it's tough to bring him down. Looked a little slow on that one, that's why I say that. Well, he gets the first down. Let's go back to him here. Or not. What are you giving me? All right. Nice. Nicholson comes down, makes the catch in front of the linebackers. Having a day. 3 for 36 and a touchdown. We're moving here. Can we hit him with a jet sweep? Nah, no need. Let's just run it. Another counter. All right. Up the middle. Good. Second and four. Let's get into something else. Let's let the clock run a little bit here. We don't want to score too early. Second and four. Not assume we're going to score. You know, let's do it. But we're looking good so far. Going to go to Reynolds here on a handoff. All right, now we're going to call timeout. Third and one. I tried to cut it back up the middle, but that hole kind of closed last second. So, all right, going to try to do a power run to the right here out of the pistol. They're sending a blitz late, though. Let's just run it up the middle, get this yard. Maybe score. Oh, came right through. Couldn't get to us, though. Culver squirts through right up the middle. All right, we'll talk about it in a second. Let's get the touchdown. All right, clock's running. Got the two timeouts. Gonna go blast out of the Wildcat. Defense act in tight here. Follow the fullback. Yes! Just kind of wiggles his way in there. That's how it works, man. Another score. On that run, they brought the safety blitz, right? We knew that was going to happen. They showed it, at least. He came right through, for whatever reason, completely whiffed on Culver. Didn't even touch him. So, missed opportunity for Cal there, for sure. And we end up scoring a touchdown. Alright, 5 seconds to go. Looks like they're actually going to run it, so I came out in the deep zone. Can we blitz? No, I guess not. Okay. Well, it didn't really work out well for them anyway. That's going to take us to halftime there. Chris Tucker makes the tackle to wrap up the first half. 28-7, looking really good. We've had 4 touchdown drives on all 4 of our drives offensively. The ground game is working beautifully. The passing game has been effective when we needed it to be. The run is set up to pass exactly what I want to do every time I come in to play this game. My game plan is executing to perfection. The defense is playing beautifully after a hiccup on the first, second drive there. So let's keep going. Maybe get the backups in. Guys just about set to start the third quarter. Nice kick, plenty of distance. I will take the fair catch here. All right, let's keep it going, man. Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about coming out in the pistol, looking to run a read option to the left here. Oh, what was I thinking? I just completely forgot to hand it off. I was expecting him to just crash down on it. So dumb. All right, 2nd and 13. All right, let's run levels, get some of these yards back. They go soft coverage, which they are. Okay. Well, he's kind of favoring that sideline. Down. Campbell. Nice. Way to get some extra yards there. But, all right, 3rd and 4. I don't know what I was thinking on the first play. I just didn't hand it off. I don't know what. I just didn't cross my mind for whatever reason. 3rd and 4. Let's convert. And the way we've been running it today, I'm just going to go pistol and run it right up the middle. Depending on what they do. Okay. Yeah, we are. Linebacker crashes the hole very well, makes the tackle in the backfield. All right, that might deter my decision making on third downs going forward. I hadn't seen them make that kind of a play previously, so I didn't, I was like, I don't think you can make that play, so I'm going to run it on you. But now I know they can make that play, so I'll run something else on 3rd and 4 next time. Not that big of a deal. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Nice. Good job by the Gunners there, getting downfield, making them pull for the fair catch. Now let's play defense.
Offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Screen. They run. They came out with the same play to open up their first drive out of the half as in the first half. And that time we were ready for it. Another pass. Slant. Ugh, tried to get there to make the play. We do get the tackle. Third and one. Didn't recognize it until too late. But we could still get off the field here. Let's go safety blitz. Give me Davis. Let's go. Read option. Get out there, Whaley. Yes! Yes! Big stop there. Whaley comes up to make the play on the read option, and we get off the field again. Still 11 yards, though. Good return. Let's see if we can do better offensively this time. They're starting to key in on the run game. Well, they have been all day, but more so. So maybe we'll look to pass a little bit more in this possession. We're going to come out with a pass. See, this is what I don't like when they go three down linemen like that, and then we only got two linebackers. All right, they're going talking too fast. Now they're going to bring in the safety down. Throw it up. Nicholson, make a play. Oh, what a catch. Back shoulder fade up the sideline. Comes down with it. I mean, it doesn't matter who's there. I've thrown that pass like the last three games. Every time they come down with it. Doesn't matter if it's Dave, if it's Campbell, if it's Nicholson. They always come down with the football. So, you know. The trust in my receivers is as high as it could be. Huge play from Nicholson there. He is having a day today, I'll tell you. Passing again. They're going to bring another safety blitz. Drag. Or try to get a spin off. Good 5-yard gain, though. Can never be upset with that. Let's keep going with these crossing routes. They haven't really been able to stop them, so we're going to go slot drive this time. Additional pressure off the left edge here. Not there, but that one is. Campbell makes the catch in the in route. Couldn't break the tackle, but 14 yards. See, that's a good play because you got the one drag underneath and then the in route behind it. So if one's covered, you can look underneath or up top, right? All right, first and goal from the 8. We're coming out with a triple option. I don't know what they're doing defensively. Late pitch. Ah, that was kind of weird. I would have liked Reynolds to be a little bit more to my side so that pitch was more lateral. He could have walked in for a touchdown. But all right, 2-yard gain. We'll take it. All right, let's go power run here out of the pistol. Every time we wanted to run it, we've switched out of it. And looks like we might be doing that again. Let's just go up the middle. Linebackers crash down, but Culver walks right through. Great blocking, baby. The center gets up to the second level. The guard gets up to the second level. And we just run right through him, man. The offensive line has been stellar today. Unbelievable. Culver might be getting the touchdowns, but I mean, look at that. Perfect blocking. It's the O-line that makes this place happen. Alright, they should be looking to pass the ball more. They're down by 28 here, and it's getting a little late, so we're going to play cover 3. Taking off on a run, make him fumble. Nearly. That's fine, though, because that's going to keep the clock running. We're going to send some zone pressure this time, though. Out route. Had it covered on my side, but not the other side. To get the first down. I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to. Now let's mix it up and go man to man. He just threw a little dump off pass that was good enough for a first down. And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He dumps it underneath, but he drops the ball. He got scared. Whaley was right there, man. Okay, they're going to go empty, so we're going to go quarter coverage with a QB spy. And we'll play as a safety. We need the spy today because they're going to quarterback.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers.
Zig. Pick that off. Oh! What a play by Motley there, man. That wasn't even his guy. He comes off of his guy to cover that out route and should have had the interception, but he drops it. But what a play by the corner there. He's a young guy, too. He hasn't really played all that much. That's a very impressive play. Here we go, 3rd and 10. I don't know what he was doing there. Nobody was open. Scrambles out of the pocket and I guess just throws it away. 4th and 10. Great coverage there, man. Very impressive. All right, should be just a pretty nice, chill, low-key drive here. If we score a touchdown, I'll put in the backups next drive. We're going to start it out with a jet sweep swing pass. Boom, wide open. Good blocking downfield. Day in the open field. One guy to beat. Oh, gets him. Every time I run that play, it's a big hitter, man. You guys should put that one in your playbooks right there. Works like a freaking charm. Now we're going to run counter out of the power. We're having fun. We're having some fun right now. Let's go. Up the middle. Oh, good cut. Get out of that. Touchdown. Let's go, man. Don't you just love it when you experiment with plays and they actually freaking work? I mean, I don't think I've ever run that one. A little counter out of the power. Culver, you know, makes the play. He breaks the tackle. And Day gets a great block downfield. And I think it's time for the backups. Alright, keeping the starting defense in the game, probably until the fourth quarter to avoid some injuries, but there's no need to take them out now. Drops the pass, we're going to come down and absolutely light his world up, so probably a good thing he dropped that one. Then mix up the coverage again, we're going to go cover 3 zone this time, keep him thinking. Alright, late motion. Slant, hits the underneath, nice tackle, nothing there. Let's safety blitz here. Damn, we got picked up. Ah, slant! Hey, Ewing. He gets burned on slants. Like, you can't cover the slant in this game unless you're the one actually covering. It's kind of annoying. All right, they pick up the first down. That's got to be picked off. Yes, sir, Davis. Get that block for me, Tucker. Yes. Woo! Drew Davis gets an interception. I'm not sure how many he's had this season, but 3-year starter at free safety, making plays, man. That's probably the easiest one he'll ever have right there. All right, it's time for the backups. Let's go. Andy Gaither's going to be the guy at quarterback next year, so we're going to get him some reps at the end of the game here. Just some nice, chill reps. Oh, good block. Yes, sir. Nice big run on first down. Look at, did you see 68? I mean, this is a backup, too. Look, he pancakes his guy and then picks up the safety for me. Man, new appreciation for offensive linemen. You guys are the real goats. All right, let's give Gaither a nice easy throw to ease in here. Unless they do that. He is a running threat, so we're going to keep working on it. I'm not sure where he was going there. I was trying to just go up the middle, but whatever. Worked out. Now, these quick base plays are a little sus because you're pulling the right guard so the linebacker can shoot through, but we'll give it a try. I try to avoid these as much as possible. I mean, that's kind of why right there. They did end up getting downhill, but Reynolds is able to squirt through the hole. And I think that's going to, yeah. Let's go to the fourth quarter. Still got a whole freaking quarter to play. Are they going to run the clock? Or there we go. All right. Still got a whole quarter to play. Got the backups in, though, so let's keep you know, let's get them some reps. A lot of these guys you'll probably see next year have a huge role in the team, especially the quarterback. So, but as far as the first teamers go, very good performance today. Just absolutely dominant. Everything you expected played against a 3-5 team. And we're starting to click on all cylinders at the perfect time late in the season. As far as backup running back, it's not really a backup because Reynolds has come in and played crucial minutes this season. So, you know, he's not new to this. 24, that is, I'm talking. Boom. Sent the corner on the blitz. Beverly wide open on the out route. Good throw from Gaither. And we got to fix this helmet. He's got the Revo speed. Ugh. No, not even the speed. It's just the revolution. That's gross. We're gonna fix you up, Beverly. He's just a freshman, so I kind of try and wait for guys to show me what they can do before I, you know, swag them out. But I can't have you looking like that on my team. Just can't. All right, first and goal from the 8. Coming out with this. Not gonna run that. We're gonna run it right up the middle. Boom. Easy, baby. My second team O-line is just as good as my first team. I mean, we've recruited the position very well in the past couple years. It was not a position of strength when we got to Oregon State. They're putting on a show today. Second team defense in the game. Let's see who we like here.
There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
Back to the receiver. A lot of these guys though play some big minutes on first team, so you know it's kind of like, you know, some guys you'll see you're familiar with, but you know, especially the guys in the D line are newer because they don't get that much time. What the? Makes the catch. All right, not sure why that wasn't intercepted. Checked it down. We had a guy right there, though. And he makes the play. Didn't see who that was. Might have been J.J. Brock, the backup middle linebacker. Let's see the back of the jersey here. Oh, or not. Yeah, I think it was. All right, 3rd and 4. Let's go. Going to go cover 2 spy. We're going to press the corners in zone coverage.
Defensive coordinator.
Let's get off the field.
Anticipating this 5-wide set. He comes in with his dime package.
Man. Checks it down. Motley lays the lick. But they get the first down. That's fine. We're just having fun. Let's try man coverage. See what my backups can do. Sephora Verts all the way. And we get the sack. Let's go, baby. There we go. Who got that one? Jeff Gates gets the sack. My man. He plays on first team, but he's out here getting some good second team reps. And look at how big he is. I mean, sheesh. Nice sack there. He is built. You're going to see him quite a bit down the line here. All right, 2nd and 18. Let's go.
Wide receivers.
Zig route. They check it down. That's not going to do you any good. 3rd and 12.
That brings up 3rd and 12.
Let's go. Let's get off the field, defense.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts.
4 verts. Going up top. Oh, Dunbar got burned over there.
And he shoved out of bounds.
And the safety help was late. Damn.
It definitely put them in better field position. I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
That sucks. All right.
Come out on an empty back.
Let's go. Shake it off, baby.
Let's it fly.
Oh, Dunbar again. That was against a cover 3, too.
Great effort by the wide receiver.
Well, there's a reason why he's second team, I guess. But Cal gets a garbage time touchdown. No biggie. Oh, they're going to go onside.
This is strange. The kicking team is looking to kick the onside.
All right. Here's a tip. If you ever want to go from regular kickoff coverage to onside return, it's XA. All right. That's all I did there. Wasn't expecting him to come out with an onside kick. Good recovery from the fullback. And we're starting their territory. We've only been stopped once today, and it was because we punted. So we've had a very dominant offensive performance today, to say the least. Good blocks. Why is Culver in there?
Gets the ball. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 30.
Are my backups? The big thing is, you know, it's nice to get the backup some reps, but it's the big thing is, you know, injuries. I can't have a season-ending injury here if we don't need them. And Reynolds is, oh, I didn't think he was going to get that block. Reynolds is just as capable of making plays, so, you know, why risk Culver getting an injury? All right, let's get out of this. This is my go-to, go-to audible. Boom. Get the foot down. Campbell. Jeezy. Probably the best receiving day of his career, if I'm not mistaken. All right, I think they're going to be expecting a run here, so we're coming out with a pass play. And we'll stick with it. Ooh, running back. Reynolds! Oof! Nearly. Probably had another option there, but you know, I looked to the drag, then I looked to the running back. They dropped into a zone, so you know, it's like a free couple yards. Play action, but I don't run pass plays inside the five. It's stupid. Saying our first rodeo. Oh, maybe I should have. Good play from Cal there. We're gonna go Wildcat. All right, gonna need Jamal Van to pick up that overhang defender there. All right, first of all, I definitely was holding A, and then two, my fullback just completely took me out of the play there. Whatever. All right, we're going to kick the field goal. I was in the wrong set anyway. Gaither was still in the game there. I should have had the running back in. I don't know. Whatever. We'll just kick our chip shot field goal and move on. All right, we hit the 50 burger for you guys. Now we're going to kick it back to him. See if we can get a stop with the backups. And Stanford picks up a good win, 30-17 over Oregon, the team we're going to be playing here later in the season. But Stanford moves to 6-3 and 4-2 in the Pac-12, I want to say. USC held off Arizona and UCLA got it. But USC, 7-2, 7-1 in conference. Only losses to us, but they played a lot of conference games.
He's to the 20. Tackle made. A touchdown.
All right, 2:45 to go. Got the backups in the game still. Got burned last possession, so let's see if we can do a better job. Look at you, Dunbar. Oh, I should have held Y. I can't believe he actually threw that. I was all over it. J.J. Brock, good coverage, baby. Future middle linebacker. Remember the name.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers.
Actually gonna run it. I don't know why.
And down he goes, around the 36-yard line.
Let's go back to man coverage. Screen. Underwood, let's go, baby! True freshman, let's go! He's the future of the secondary, Brian Underwood. Something, guys. We're going to have to play man coverage when you're starters, so let's see if we can do it now. Slant. We're all over that. Pretty good coverage on that one, actually. Got some help from Washington underneath, but you know, he was on that for the most part. Run a screen here. Draw. Boom! Nice hit! Who got that one? Was it Early Carter? I think it was Early Carter. The sickest name I've ever had in a college football player right there. Defensive end. The future of the DN position. One of the highest rated recruits in Oregon State history right there. He's a beast. Alright, 1:27 to go. They got three timeouts. We're going to run a couple plays. Maybe try a few things. And keep it real. Woo! Nice move, Travis. Why are the starters in the game? Bruh. I appreciate your tenacity to get out there against a terrible team and rack up your stats, but we can't have you getting hurt, you know? go, Reynolds.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Let's try another play out of this formation. We ran the swing pass out of this, and it worked very well, so let's try a triple option. That swing pass is definitely one I'm going to keep in mind, though, for like an opening play. Because, you know, you walk into the game, you know, you try to set the mood. I usually just go with the midline read option, but that swing pass is a nice, easy completion that has potential to be a big hitter. So that's something I might come and, you know, try to use in the opening play of the game going forward. Let's give Campbell a chance to score here, though. Burned him. Get the throw off, easy. Boom.
It's the sophomore that's got it for the 20.
Damn. Tried to run the rest of the time off, but Gary Campbell exposes the corner on a little streak. Makes the catch. Easy touchdown for him. I hate to run up the score like that. Well, actually, don't. I hate everybody, so. Whatever. Gaither gets a nice touchdown. Little Dez Bryant action there running across the field. Finally, we can end the game on a kickoff like that instead of there being 1 second left. But what a win, man. 59-14. I know what you're thinking. Oh, well, you should have won the game. Yeah, but, you know, in today's day and age of college football, man, if you can do what you're supposed to the way you're supposed to do it, it's a great feeling. So we got the backups in today, had a little bit of fun, discovered some new plays we might like to use in the future. Another great game, especially on the ground. We just dominated. I think we scored all but two of our touchdowns on the ground. So just very impressive, very pleased with the team. And now I think we're going to get a bye week before we run that gauntlet that we did last year. And I don't know what to say here. We weren't able to run the gauntlet. We're going to play Oregon State. We're going to play Washington first, then Washington State, and then Oregon in the Civil War. Last year we lost to Washington State. So we're going to try and go 3-0 this time to end it. It's a very special thing. They don't even do it in real life, I don't think. They play all three of their rivals. We play all three of our rivals back to back to back. Washington, Washington State, and Oregon. It's very fun. We weren't able to win them all last year. Washington State has given me fits every single year with their stupid air raid offense they run. But we're going to try and get it done this year. We got to beat Washington first, though. But let's go to the post game, see if there's anything to take care of there, and we'll close it out. All right, like I said, bye week, move to 9-0. I'm not sure there's much to take care of in this section. We'll take a look and advance one more time. But we do move to a 22 wins in a row home win streak. So I think it's 22. Just double check that. Yep, 22. So that's hype. Good little win. Let's see if we had any player of the game type of stuff. We got award semifinals, we can check that out. No national, okay, no, that's fine. Let's check a few more things. See if we went up in this. We do, number three, let's go. As you can see, 22 game win streak, and it's because Ohio State lost the game at home. So that's hype. Oh, we're behind USC and Michigan. 27 wins in a row. Wow. USC has won 8 in a row, probably because we beat them last in their field. Whatever. No big deal. Award semifinals. I'm sure we got a couple on the list here. Maxwell for the best quarterback. Oh, surprisingly, no Lewis there. He's had a quiet year, honestly, but none for the running back as well. Here we go. So this one's for the best overall defender, I believe. We got 5 guys on the list. Butler is leading. Number one, he's our middle linebacker. 7 TFLs, a sack, 2 picks on the year, so that's hype for him. Drew Davis, not far behind. 5 TFLs. That was his first pick of the year he got today. A sack, forced fumble. Chris Tucker has a pick. A scoop and score? It doesn't say interception. He has a touchdown. Must be a scoop and score. 4 TFLs. Jordan Washington, interception, a sack, 11 tackles for loss. Whew. Very, very solid, strong safety. It says free, but he's my strong. And then Michael Ewing, one of my corners, 3 TFLs and an interception. Hasn't really had a big statistical year, but, you know. This one's for the best linebacker. Oh, no. Nagurski. Maybe it's for one of the best front seven defenders. Butler is fifth in that one. Washington, ninth. And the leader is a DN because, you know, they rack up. I mean, look at it. 24 TFLs, 8 sacks. Yeah, no, you're not winning that one. Sorry. This one for the best overall offensive best quarterback? We go through all of them? I don't think so. All right, Biletnikoff. Nope. I got to brush up my trophies. Clearly. Nothing for the Mackey for tight end. We don't really use our tight end all too much. Outland, Remington. That one's for one of the better O-line. Our O-line is the best in the country. I mean, you saw it today. It was on full display. JT Brown in third for the Lombardi. He's had a good year. 7 TFLs, 2 sacks. Not a big, you know, I mean, look at these other guys. 24 TFLs, 8 sacks. I mean, he's a 93 overall. So his production, you know, it's just hasn't been great. But, you know, when I need him to make the plays, he's made it. Derek Green, my D-tackle. 11th, 5 sacks, 8 TFLs. Pretty deserving. I wonder what this one's for, best linebacker. Butler, number one, baby. Let's go. So maybe he can win two of those. Gotta keep performing here. Got a few games left to win. But Thorpe, oof, we got a lot of guys on this one. Drew Davis, this one's for the best secondary player, I believe. So Davis is second. A Vanderbilt corner is in the lead there. He has 2 touchdowns, so I guess that's why. We might pull ahead and end up winning this one, though, I feel like. The usual's in there. And then we have one more down here. George McGuire, freshman strong safety. Good to see him get up there. 7 TFLs in the sack. The Groza, Sullivan's right there. 10 for 11 on field goals. Made every extra point. My beef with this guy is he can't make anything outside of 45 yards. It's kind of, he reminds me of the Barstool Sports, the kicker. Blanking on his name. Put it in the comment section for me. Good buddies with Barstool, Big Cat. But he's automatic from inside 35 yards. But anything outside of that, you know, he can't hit. So, but he's been a good solid kicker for me. We got a freshman redshirting this year who's going to be much better. And here we go, best return. I think we've won this every year for the past 3 seasons. It looks like Ryan Culver is going to be the next guy. 4 kickoff return touchdowns this season. He had a streak there of 3 games in a row with one. Didn't get one yesterday or in the game today. Last week, I don't know. All right, but that's the award semifinals. Let's look at the Pac-12 conference standings. All right, so we're still up at number one, obviously. 9-0, 6-0. Stanford, 5-3, so right behind us. And I think now we may have clinched it. May or may not. I think we need to win one more. But because if we lose all 3, we beat Stanford head-to-head, right? So then we would get the nod to go. Now, the only thing is if Washington beats us, Oregon beats us, or Washington State beats us, and then they win out, they would go. And no, only Washington and Oregon, I believe, because State has the 4 losses. But we're not going to lose any games in the regular season. Don't plan on it. So it looks like it's going to be us and USC. We are far and away the best 2 teams in the Pac-12, us being better. UCLA, 3rd, 4-2 in conference. I don't think they're going to do enough to get up and challenge. Have they even played USC yet? Let's see. Yeah, they haven't yet. So that's going to be their last game of the year. That's right. They play in the rivalry. So, but I don't think USC is going to beat them. I mean, at least they should. I'd love to see UCLA play us in the Pac-12 championship, give us some parity, but I don't see it happening. So that's the Pac-12. We're number one in all the polls, so no sense looking at that. We will check the Heisman watch for Culver's sake. And he moved up to number 2. Look at that. On a 19 carry, 166 yard, 3 touchdown performance. So, respect. And yeah, that just about covers it. Check recruiting and just see what's up. Yeah, so here's the thing. I want to offer this guy, but if I do, he's just going to commit to our school instantly. So I'm not going to do that. He's not even that good. So. So these 2 guys here, we're in battles for. If we win them, great. If not, you know, no big deal. We got plenty of guys in this class. trust my evaluation, so I think we're good on recruiting. I'm going to continue to say that. But let's go ahead and advance to the next week. Okay, so some movement on the recruiting front. All right, the one tight end that was on our board just committed to somebody else. I think it was Clemson. Let's take a look. Not that I really care. Yep, Clemson. So, you know, easy way for me to just figure that problem out. So let's go ahead and boot him off the list. I think we don't really need a tight end, I don't think. Yeah, we have the two sophomores, Jamal Vann and Will Wallace. So it's not something I need to take care of this year. But obviously, you don't want to have just two guys in a position group. So I'll probably get one next cycle. But yeah, no big deal there. So that figures that out, basically. Let's see what we're ranked. We dropped to 6, but like I said, we are going to drop because we're not taking guys every week like these other schools are. So no big deal there. And this video's gone on for a long time, so I'm going to wrap it up. Taking on Washington next week, they are better than they usually are. 6-3, so not many above 500 teams in the Pac-12, so this one should be fun. It's the first of 3 rivalry games we're going to play back-to-back-to-back. We beat them last year pretty handily. I'll tag that video here. All my other content's going to be tagged up here at the end as well. Feel free to check it out. I've done, this is now my second season, almost done with it. So check out my first season. It's a whole series. You can just wipe through them during this entire break, you know, if you have some free time on your hands. But like I said at the beginning, road to 100 subs, baby. Like, share, subscribe. Get me up to 100 before the end of the year. Love you guys. Appreciate the continued support. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll be back soon with this game against UW. Let's go. Dynamical on the beats.